the steel stocks are off their lows, as the flash at the bottom of your screen tells you. Tata Steel is actually up 0.64%. Metals, by the way, have done very well this week. Yesterday also, most stocks were higher. Sale is also picking up from the day's low. And I think the non-steel names, Hindalco, Vedanta, Nalco, were some of the others which did fairly well in a trade yesterday. Okay, so what we're going to do is just list out a few more names from the broader market which are doing very well. So the ADAG pack is all doing well. Reliance Infra, Reliance Capital, Reliance Power comes up on my screen. Large volumes once again, so I think second day running now. Madhusudan Sumi is up about 5.5%, so 143. It's coming up as the third top traded stock across the board. India Bulls Ventures is up 6%. I think yesterday again, this is second day running again for the India Bulls group stocks doing well. We have Avanti Feed, which is up 5.5%. This is a new one. And then there's Tin Plate, 4%. And then you go down the list, but I think volumes, generally speaking, have come off quite a bit. Can't spot very much, which is doing well with large volumes at this point in time. Okay, let's bring in Ashwini at 11:30 as always with a quick check on what he's making of things. Ashwini, morning. 5-6 point change, absolutely flat. What would you do?
See, basically, the Nifty, Bank Nifty, they both gap down, and from lower levels, they are moving up. So that way, while we broke down below 10,800, but there isn't great deal of momentum on the downside. So my sense is that you should be able to buy into Nifty and Bank Nifty now, and at some point, this 15-20 point deficit will get taken out, and we should be able to move above 10,750-800. So that way, this dip should be used to buy into the market, because Bank Nifty is lower by 160 odd points. I think this is a good place to buy into it. 26,950 is a strong support on Bank Nifty. So having said that, SBI is a buy with a stop of 265, target of 282. Bank of India is a buy with a stop of 82, target of 90. And PNB is a buy with a stop of 71, target of 90.
Okay, well, we have a query now. Ashwini, Vinayak holds 20 shares of Page Industries, bought at 30,000 per share, willing to hold it for 1 to 2 years. What is your advice on it, Page?
I don't know whether something will happen in 1 or 2 years, given that this is a very overvalued stock. Unless you can do, some sort of SIP and keep doing it for, an year or two, unlikely that, 20,000 will become 30,000. My sense is, while you can continue to hold on, it's a good stock, etc., but do it like a, some sort of an SIP, so that your prices are fairly low by the time the stock turns, and if you can bring your average down to say 20,000-22,000, then getting back to 32,000-34,000 is fairly simple. So buy it, but maybe the growth is not as big as earlier, so try to buy it slowly.
Okay, try to buy it slowly is the advice coming in from Ashwini at this point in time. Ashwini, look at a stock like Uflex, if you will. It corrected the recent high. I'm not even talking about the all-time high. From 250, it went down to 180 odd rupees or so, back above 200. Any sense here? If this small cap, mid cap rally continues for a few more days, worth picking out names from that list?
It's been a decent stock over the number of years, and now 200 day moving average here is about 280, and went down vertically from 250 to 190. So somewhere this is the kind of stock where you want to buy into it, but as part of a portfolio, not like your individual stock, I think 180 to 200 has been strong support zone. So this could be one of your 15 stock portfolios.
Okay. All right, Ashwini, we leave it on that note. Thanks thanks very much for joining in, bringing us all of those technical views. We need to take a break now.